Having seen spin's approach to extensibility, now we will look at exokernel's approach to operating system extensibility. The name exokernel itself comes from the fact that the kernel exposes hardware explicitly to the operating system extensions living above it. The basic idea in exokernel is to decouple authorization of the hardware from its actual use. Let's say you want to do research in my lab. I may interview you, and once we're on the same page, I'll give you a key to the lab and the resources you need in order to do work in the lab. Example, laptops, servers, and so on. Then I get out of the way when you actually use the resources. That's exactly the same idea in exokernel. Library operating system asks for a resource. Exokernel will validate the request for the resource from the library and bind the request to the specific hardware resource. In other words, exokernel exposes the hardware that was requested by the library OS through creating a secure binding between the ask and the actual hardware resource. Once exokernel has established this binding, it creates an encrypted key for the resource and gives it to the requesting library operating system. Similar to the analogy that I gave you of a student using my lab resources, the semantics of how the resource is going to be used by the library is entirely up to the library. Of course, within the norm of accepted use, similar to what I may impose as certain restrictions or rules of behavior that students have to observe in the lab. Same way, there are certain accepted norms for the use of the resource that exokernel may have imposed. And so long as the library operating system is staying within those norms, then the semantics of how a particular hardware resource is used is entirely up to the library operating system. Once a library operating system has asked for a resource and exokernel has created the binding for that resource to the requesting library operating system, then the operating system is now ready to use the resource. Now, how does it use the resource? Basically, what the library operating system will do is present the encrypted key that it received, authenticating that use of the resource for this library to the exokernel. In other words, exokernel will be able to validate whether the key presented to it is the key that was presented to this particular library's operating system. So in other words, the key cannot be forged, cannot be passed around. If I gave a key to this library operating system, that key, if it is presented to the exokernel by this library operating system, it's a valid key. Even if it is a valid key, but it is not the operating system to which exokernel gave the key, then that request will be denied. So with a valid key, anytime the library operating system can present the key to the exokernel, exokernel will validate it, and then the library operating system is free to go in using that resource for which it has this valid key. This is sort of like a doorman in an apartment building checking when a resident comes in whether the resident is a bona fide occupant of the residence. Once inside his apartment, what the resident does is not something that the doorman cares about. Exactly the same thing is being done by exokernel as a doorman for using the hardware resource for which a valid key exists with a library operating system. So establishing the secure binding is a heavy-duty operation. That's where exokernel comes in the middle of saying, well, this particular library operating system wants access to a specific resource. Can I give it? And it makes that decision. Once such a secure binding has been established, the actual use of the hardware is going to be much cheaper.